Hello and welcome to this Necromunda painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to take your battle-ready squat gang member up to a parade-ready level. As you can see here, we've already painted it to a battle-ready level, so if you want to know how to do that, check out our previous video. Now, the first thing we're going to do is concentrate on that white armour. So we're going to re-layer with grey sear on the raised edges and then finish off with a highlight of pallid witch flesh. So first of all, let's start with our grey sear. So what I'm going to do is just apply a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water just so it's not too thick and goopy. And I'm just going to spin the brush a couple of times, get a nice point, and then we're ready to start layering that up. So what I'm going to do is just get those raised areas, like so, and just neaten them up a little bit. Just add a little bit more punch to that white. That tied up now done, what we're now going to do is get some pallid witch flesh and just finish off with some little highlights here and there. So I'm just going to pick out some of these rivets, and also some of the hard edges as well. Where possible, just use the edge of your brush to get a nice consistent line. With that pallid witch flesh highlight now done, our white armour is completed. So what we're going to do now is move on to that green cloth. So we're going to re-layer the cloth again using Castellan Green and finish off with a highlight of Deathwood Forest. But first of all, let's start with that re-layering. So what I'm going to do is get some of the Castellan Green onto my palette, not too much, and a little bit of water. It's always important to get that nice point to the brush, like so. And all I'm going to do is then just start tidying up those raised areas. Again, try not to get in the recesses because you'll undo all that shading. I'll just pick out those raised bits, and not too much on the legs. With the cloth tidied up, we're now just going to highlight with Deathwood Forest. So I'm just going to start on the top here of the sleeves, just work my way around. You want this highlight to be a bit thinner than the tidying up stage, just to give you some nice definition. With that cloth done, what we're now going to do is move on to highlighting the gun casing. So we're going to start first by using Cabalite Green, then finish off with a little highlight here and there of Saberite Green. But first of all, let's start with that Cabalite Green. So it's a layer paint, so you don't need to thin it down too much, but I'm just going to add a little bit, and then I'm going to get my brush to a nice point. It's key here when we're doing any edge highlighting to get a nice point on your brush. And once we've done that, we're then ready to start picking out. So I'm just going to find some hard edges here on the actual gun casing itself. This is just a pistol, so it's a little bit smaller, but some of the other weapons in the set have a little bit more gun casing on them. With that first highlight now done, we're just going to use a little bit of Saberite Green to pick out some of those corners and rivets. Again, not too much because we still want to see some of that Cabalite showing through. With our gun casing completed, what we're now going to do is move on to highlighting up the black leather. We're going to start first by using some Storm Vermin Fur as a highlight. Then to make it look a little bit scruffy and worn, we're going to use a little bit of Carrick Stone here and there. But first of all, let's start with our first highlight. So I'm just going to get some Storm Vermin Fur on my palette, a little bit of water, and get a good point to the brush. Yeah, just twisting it around until it's got a nice point to it. And then we're ready to start highlighting up that leather. So I'm just going to start with the belt here. And all I'm going to do is just run my brush along those raised edges. Do that across any black detail you got, such as boots, pouches, gloves. Now that we've highlighted the leather up, we're just going to make it look a little bit worn and tatty by just getting some Carrick Stone, and we're just going to, instead of highlighting, I'm just going to do little stabby motions like this. As you can see, it's just making it look a little bit frayed and old. I'm just going to carry that on all throughout any of the black highlights. Just little stabby motions. Take your time and don't do every highlight, just bits here and there. Now that we've made our black leather look nice and scruffy, what we're now going to do is move on to that helmet. So I'm going to start first by highlighting that yellow with Flash Gitch Yellow. Then we're going to move on to that red stripe. For that, we'll be using Blood Angels Red. And then we'll finish off with Hard Coat on the visor. But first of all, let's start with our highlight. So I'm going to get some Flash Gitch Yellow, apply a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water. And the key thing there is just get a nice point to your brush. And then we're ready to start highlighting that yellow. So I'm just going to start on the little brim at the front. And like we did with the leather, I'm just going to do some little dashes like so. So it just looks a bit chipped and battered. And we'll move around to the back. Got a couple of like little ridges here. So I'm just going to just do some nice little stripes down there as well. You can take your time. If you're making a mistake, you can always tidy back up with those base paints. With the helmet highlighted, what we're now going to do is pick out that red marking. Now you can make these as thick or as thin as you like, but I'm going to use the thickness of this little top part here. So all I'm going to do is just move my way around and just start by doing a broad line following the contours of that top ridge. Now you obviously need to be as neat as you can. The great thing with Blood Angel's red is as it dries, it will show some of that color through. So where you've highlighted, you'll see some of that as well. Just take your time. And if you do need to tidy back up with Avalanche Sunset, just pop that out and make any corrections where necessary. With the red stripe picked out, what we're now going to do is get some hard coat and apply that to the lens. So what I'm going to do here is just, like I said, I'll just apply it straight onto the Cantor blue. It's going to make it look shiny and like it's made out of glass. Now that our helmet's completed, what we're now going to do is move on to the final details of this model. We're going to start first by using Stormhost Silver. This is to highlight all the metallics of the brass and the silvers, but I'll also use it to pick out the headlamp and the screen on his gauntlet. After that, we're going to use Kislev Flesh to highlight the face, then Ethematic Blue to pick out the glowy effect on the lamp as well as the screen on his gauntlet. So first of all, let's start with our Stormhost Silver. So apply a little bit to the palette, a little bit of water. So make sure we get a good point to our brush. And then once we're ready, we'll start highlighting that silver. So I'm just going to go on the gun to pick out some of those raised areas and edges. With all those metallics now picked out with Stormhost Silver, we're going to move on to Kislev Flesh. Now for this, we're just going to concentrate on the face. So I'm going to do the nose and lips. Now that we've picked out the face, what we're now going to do is apply Ethematic Blue to both the headlamp and also the little heads-up display on his wrist. I'm just going to apply that on there first, just avoiding those little bars either side. I'll pick out these little ones as well. Like I said, we'll just get some more on our brush and then just apply it to the screen. With the Ethematic Blue now applied, our model is almost finished. So what we're now going to do is finish it off by just adding a little bit of a highlight to that base. For this, we're going to use Carrick Stone. So I'm going to get a small dry brush, and all I'm going to do is load up my brush with some Carrick Stone, not too much. What we're aiming to do is remove as much of that pigment as possible. So I'm just doing circular motions and crisscross motions. I'll just move to the side slightly, so there's still a little bit of pigment there. So I'm happy with that. And all I'm going to now do is then start dry brushing that onto the texture. I'm just going to go back and forth like so. You can see it's just starting to pick out those raised areas, yet leaving that darker tone deep in the recesses. And with that dry brush on the base now done, our Ironhead Squat Ganga is now completed. With our squat now painted up to parade ready, he's fully prepared to face any dangers the world of Necromunda can throw at him. Now there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any edge highlighting, just take your time and maintain a nice point to your brush. Also, when doing any dry brushing, try and remove as much of that pigment as possible. You can always do a couple of passovers if you need to as well. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own squat gangers, and we'll see you again soon. Bye bye.